children, in this video we will discuss your 15th chapter, probability. Now probability you people are studying from 7th standard, but from 7th to 9th, what probability you have studied, that probability is totally based on the result of a probability. Suppose, what I mean to say, suppose I will toss a coin. Toss a coin 1000 times. So number of head will occur. Suppose it is 550 times, and I am getting tail 450 times. So probability to get head is 550 upon 1000, and probability to get tail is 450 upon 1000. Such probability you have studied till now. What probability you have studied? Which probability is exactly actually belonging to the result of your experiment? Result of an experiment. Now, in 10th standard, we are moving one step ahead. Here, we are going to study classical probability, or you can say theoretical aspect of a probability. What it means? It is also, as it is saying, just a very minor difference. Whenever you have observed a probability question, a most familiar question, that is a tossing a die, whenever this question is written, they are always used to write unbiased coin. Unbiased coin means probability chances to get head are as equal to chances to get a tail. Pay attention. If I am tossing a coin one time only, so that time it may possible I will get head, it may possible I will get tail. If I toss a coin 20 times, it may possible 20 times if I toss, it may possible 15 times I will get head and 5 times only I will get tail. If I take this experiment like more number of times, suppose 100 times. So whenever you will increase this number, your answer will be nearly equals to 1 by 2. Why you are getting 1 nearly equals to 1 by 2? Because your coin is unbiased coin. Head and tail both are having equal chances to occur. One more example, most familiar example of a die. Die having how many outcomes? 6 outcomes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So, if I throw a die, so 6, total number of outcomes are, total possibilities are, 6 outcomes are. Among these 6 numbers, each and every number having equal chances of occurrence. So, probability to occur 1 is 1 by 6, probability to get 4 is again 1 by 6, probability to get 6, you are not supposed to write 6 by 6, that is 1. No, this is a wrong question. How many times 6 you are having? Only 1 time. So it will be 1 by 6. It means we can say all are equally likely outcomes. One more question of a that I will tell you. So, before moving on a card problem, here conclusion is only one, that whatever problem now onwards we are going to discuss, in which it may possible that the number of chances of occurrence of a particular outcomes are not equal, even though we have to assume this one is an equally likely outcome. I will give you one example. Suppose I am having one bucket. In this box, I am having 4 red colored balls and only 1 blue color. By a single glance, if you will observe it, you can tell me, madam, it is more likely that I will get a red color ball. But if I take without looking into a bucket, if I hold one ball, if I am going to take one ball from it, that time each ball having an equal number of chances. So that is why be considered as an equally likely outcome. Though, if you will observe, you will feel like these are 4 balls. This one is a 1 ball. There are more chances that I will get a red ball. It may be possible. You can argue like this. But this is correct. your argument is correct. But when I will draw, when you are flipping a coin, that time head or tail, both are having equal chances. Well, because coin is unbiased. This one is also case as it is same. I am having one bucket in which some balls are kept in it. Now, without looking into it, if I am going to take out one ball, so that time all five balls are having equal chances. Is it understood? So what is the classical probability? What is its theoretical aspect? Here, now onwards, you have to consider that whatever probability we are going to find in 10th standard, in which all are equally likely outcome. Equally likely outcomes means all are having equal chances of occurrence. Now see, one more question. Now all of you just pay attention. Probability is always ranging between 0 to 1. Means lowest probability is 0, highest probability is 1. Your answer can be ranging between 0 to 1. More than 1 and less than 0 if you are getting, that is impossible. Now, what is when we are getting a 0? What type of event we have, that time we will get a 0. So, suppose I am having a die. I will take a very simple example. I am throwing one die. I am rolling it. What is the probability that a 7 number face will occur? On the die, only 1 to 6 numbers were written. 7 number is not there, which is impossible. So, on such cases, result will be 0. Understood? 1 is considered as a complete probability. Suppose, here, what is the probability to get a red color ball? What is the probability to get a blue color ball? This question, I am leaving up to you. Just try to solve this question. The easy question which we have solved in your earlier classes also, in 9th standard also. I am not going to solve this question. You people can solve it very easy, simple, 7th or 8th standard question. But before solving 2-3 questions of a probability, I just want to give you one clear chart of a death problem, because these death problems are always creating confusion in your mind. So, clear question. In a deck of cards, there are total 52 cards. These 52 cards are divided into 26 and 26. This half 26 are red color cards. These are of a black color cards. These red color cards are also dividing into the suits of 13 and 13. Two collections of 13s are there. One is heart. Second one, diamond. Here, this black is also dividing in a 13 and 13. This one 13, this one 13. This one is a spade, this one is. Now see, again there will be a question. Madam, 52 cards are there. These 52 cards are divided into two color cards. 26 are of red, 26 are of black. This 26 red again dividing into two parts of 13, 13. 13 are heart, 13 are diamond. These black cards are also dividing into two parts, 13, 13. 13 are spade, this 13 are club. Now, these 13 cards containing which? So, in each suit, there are king, queen, jack, ace, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3 and 2. Total, if you want to count, these are total 13 cards. Now observe. King is here also. Jack is here also. Here also. It means you can conclude that each card is repeating 4 times. So in a deck, how many kings we have? 4. How many queens we have? 4. How many aces we have? 4. Understood? So each card here repeating 4 times. Till here is it understood? Now see, one more question they are asking, what about a face card? So face card means you have to consider queen, king and jack. So these are 4, total 12 face cards are. mind, you can solve any question based on this card. Now I will solve 2-3 questions to give you proper understanding of a probability, so to avoid a confusion. Based on card only, I am taking this question. Your question is, one card is drawn from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards. Calculate the probability that the card will be an ace. Card will be an ace. Card will be an ace. I have to conclude is the probability. How I will calculate? How many A's are there? One ace is here, one is here, one is here, one is here. So your favorable outcomes will be 4. Total number of outcomes are 52. So this is the probability to get an ace. Your second question, not an ace. Not an ace means what? Two things are there. You can do like A's are 4. So not an ace means 52 minus 4 divided by 52. Or one more way. We are knowing that complete probability is 1. If I want to find out its complement, so it will be 1 minus 4 by 52, it will give you direct answer. So if I am considering that let E be the event to get an A, so I will get P of E plus P of E bar, which is the complement of that event, which is equals to 1. So if I am having P of E, so easily I can get 1 minus P of E bar. And if I want to calculate not an A, so it will be 1 minus P of E, as I need to calculate here an A. Two more important questions I want to discuss about a probability. Second question, Harpreet tosses two different coins simultaneously. What is the probability that she gets at least one head? Two coins she is tossing at a time. It means what are the possibilities to get the outcomes in a sample space? Both can be head, one head, second tail, first tail, second head, both can be tail. We have to find out the probability to get at least one head. At least one head means at least means minimum one I want. More than one head is one heads are there. Okay, accept it. But minimum one, at least means what? Minimum one. So how many? Two accepted, one accepted, one accepted, this one now. So probability to get at least one head is equals to 3/4. Hope this thing is also clear to you, because this at least and at most mostly creating confusion. At least one means what? Minimum one. At most one means what? Maximum one. Suppose I will ask, what is the probability to get at most one head? At most one head means maximum one head I want. So how many? 1, 2. So at that time it will be 2/4. At most two head. So 2/4, that is 1. Understood? Now, one more last question based on your die I want to discuss here. Third question. Two die, one blue, one gray, are thrown at the same time. If I am throwing two die, pay attention to me. Two die. So this one is my first die. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Die having 6 outcomes. Let this one is my gray die and this one is my blue die. It is also having 6 outcomes. 4, 5, 6. If I throw both simultaneously, so what outcomes I will get? 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. Like this here also. 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. Similarly, 3-1, 3-2, 3-3, 3-4, 3-5, 3-6. Here, 4-1, 4-2, 4-4, sorry, 4-3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6. Like this, you have to calculate sample space. Here also, 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6. One more. Last one. 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, 6, 6. So children, this one is your sample space. How many elements are there in a sample space? 36. Number of elements in a sample space are 6, 6, 6, 6 are 36 elements. Now see, what is your question? Write down all the possible outcomes. We have written all the possible outcomes. What is the probability that the sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of the die is 8? Sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of the die is 8. Maximum is 6. Here 7. Not possible. This one sum is 8.
This one
3 plus 5, 8. 4 plus 4, 8. 5 plus 3, 8. 6 plus 2, 8. How many outcomes we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So probability to get sum of number is 8 is equals to 5 by 36. Understood? Now see, next one. What is the possibility to get sum 13? Now see, the maximum number is 6, 6. So 6 plus 6, that is 12. So highest sum is 12. What they are asking? Sum is 13. So that is impossible event. So probability to get sum is 13, which is 0. Impossible event, which is not possible to get here. So its answer will be a 0. And last one, less than or equals to 12. Sum should be less than or equals to 12. Less than means equals to 12 means 6, 6 accepted. Less than equals to means all numbers will come. 6, 5, 11, 6, 4, 10, 6, 3, 9, 6, 2, 8, 6, 1, 7. Here also you can observe. All numbers will come. So probability to get sum less than or equals to 12, which is equals all 36 outcomes will come. So 36 upon 36, that is 1. This one is known as complete probability. Or we can say sure event. Hope this topic is very well clear to you. Some more practice questions are given in assignment. You can practice.